Welcome back to Chasing the Dream on Alma, Missouri. We're still on the second part of October. We're loading up the seed conveyor. Get this fired up. There we go. Still got a little bit of fertilizer left in there. Actually, I'm going to shut that off for now. We'll run that out. Once we take a little fertilizer, if any, out of the planter, which I need to make sure that, or the cedar, which we need to make sure we are not, and I'm not going to make that turn. Wild. I want to get the tarp back on. So we're going to send this over to the main yard. I'll probably put this on field one waiting. So, what I'm going to do while we're here, we'll jump out. Okay, on our way. Okay, excellent. That washer. We need to feed our livestock this morning, or this afternoon, evening, I guess. Evening. I'm all thrown off because of the way that sun's hitting across the valley right now. It's quite beautiful. But yeah, not sure how many more episodes we'll release of this. I might keep this one going a little bit while. I was going to do the Hubbard, but a lot of people don't seem to be too interested in the Ag Advisor. Starting small and ending big, so on and so forth. So we're going to hold off probably on making any more episodes of that. And hopefully next week, you know, we can get some multiplayer going. Get something started up there, you know. Get everyone in the same place trying to figure it out together. So we shall see. But I will probably keep playing Hubbard off on the side. I really enjoyed that. Man, I am struggling to turn this right now. Sensitivity's a little too much, I think, on this. Trying to tweak things around a little bit, so it's not as much as a jump going between the steering wheel and the keyboard or the controller from time to time. That's what we're trying here today. We got the mowers running, we got the rake running over there, cow jumping in the feed mix, gotta love that. Always makes that an interesting situation. We'll get that alfalfa bale, we'll get that into the digester, and or fermenting bins, and get it taken care of. So it looks like we're just shy, so I'm going to just run right through here, like so. We'll get these gates shut up. Once I'm getting out. Perfect. One of the things I think we want to do after is I need to turn on my corn dryer again. I don't hear it running, so we'll probably tend to that. Everything else should be running. Looks like we still got enough here. We have to put some straw and hay in there. We're going to have to adjust this. Keyboard sensitivity way off. We did not find a happy neutral. What we can do is here. And like I said, we'll take a quick look. Go down here and see what we got running and what's not running. Those are all running pretty good. That's running, making grass silage, a lot of digestate down there. And yeah, the dryer's off, so let's turn that back on because we got 16,000 bushels of corn that we do need to dry, especially with the amount of moisture out there. So we'll get that up there. We'll have over, we'll have probably roughly where we are. We'll probably lose a couple hundred bushel when it goes through the drying process. It's usually what happens. Seeds, we're still producing there. That's outstanding. I think I should have looked how much we have left in the last bin on this farm, which we need to keep working on down here. Haylop's getting a little empty now, but I'm not too worried. You know, it is what it is. Let's say 154 square bales of straw left. So then we'll start just using the big straw bales and break them up. And we got a little glitch with the door going on here. Well, let's go right out here. I'm going to shut this because we have had a cow or two wander out through that door, believe it or not. We'll come over here. We'll grab some of these bales. We'll get this tossed in there. And once Tom dropped off, we'll jump over to the cedar and get some seeding going. Get that winter rye placed in. So I was telling you, we'll use the harvest, and looks like we can get one more in there. I might just throw this one on top of it. Why not, you know? So with that going there, let's jump back over to the map. Actually, let's take a look at what we're at. Solid fertilizer, we do not have much. We have a truck starting to be filled, but down at the actual Sedalia, or what needs to go to Sedalia right now, is at the train loading point, the rail station. Not much at all. Silage, obviously we can make a ton of money on that, yada, yada, yada. Corn, right now, corn, $356,000 if we sell corn the way it is. We won't see the dried corn, but to put it in perspective, dried corn is usually about $200 more, which means probably about $500,000 in corn, which is great. Seeds, we could sell some of that if we need to. 1,000 liters here, you know what it is, a couple of that, boom. And then other than that, I think we're kind of in a good place. We have the alfalfa, which I might, for the price of it, I might move that alfalfa that we didn't turn to hay. We might put that in the fermentation bins and kind of let it go there. Looks like alfalfa hay we might be hauling out and making about $38,000 on it. But we'll make more money, I think, putting the alfalfa through our fermentation. So I think that's the plan there. Yeah, while we're in here, let's run over here. Let's get this guy started up. I don't want him on a current course. We want him to create a job. Now, we do got the new course play on here, so we got to make sure. Start work on center. I mean, sure, that's fine. I like to take that down a notch. 3 headlands works for me. Should give it enough. I want to make sure they're skipping a row. Row to skip one. Let's actually go 2 on that one. And that should cover everything with the new stuff added, which I kind of like this. Controlling, you know, how sharp these corners should be. Should we be rounding them? How narrow? So that looks good right there. So I'm going to click first waypoint. We'll send them on their way with the winter rye. Get him working through it. So he should be set up shortly. He's actually going to start right over here, which is kind of nice. Like I said, we might go corn one more time in here. One of the things I'm going to do when he makes a turn here, I don't think I can adjust the seed rate with him in it, but we're going to, well, you know what? It's already kind of at the low end, right? We did set that last time. I'm pretty positive we set that to 27%. So he started there. Well, he's probably getting 2 rows out. That's what he's doing, which is fine because now what I can do is actually stop him. But I just want to make sure that we're not over fertilizing. Seed rate is also not available for rye, which is a little interesting. So we'll put that on nearest point right now. Back this up a little. And like I said, we want to just make sure our seed rate is good. Seed rate's fine. Automatic application rate, we'll change that. Like I said, I don't think we can go any lower. Yeah, that's right. We're all set up, so that's all I needed. And we'll just send him back on his way. So it'll burn through some fertilizer, which is fine. And at one point, I'm even fine running it without any fertilizer if need be. Loam's not too crazy. So right here's actually just loam. We'll look at, let's go up here. So it's not bad in here. Like, it's not actually bad for soil types. We can work with it. pH level, we're good. Thought about going and doing that, but I'm not too worried. Another field that we actually do need to pH, though, is actually over at the main yard. Nitrogen level, like I said, not losing sleep over it for what we're going to turn out in corn. Corn doesn't need to be that high. We'll continue to work it and get through. Field across the dirt road, field one. We don't need any more nitrogen on that for sure. And then with beans and stuff being over there, not too worried. I might put some fertilizer down on field 13 as well. We'll see. We'll figure that out when we come to it, right? But yeah. And the yield, yeah, they were not great. We hung out 65% for those corn fields. So maybe we do bump up the fertilizer. We'll see. It's corn. You know, the other thing we can do is once we plant corn, we can drive over it and use our earned earth and cover it with fertilizer if needed. Or we do have some digestate we could use. Kind of go from there, but I think right now we're not going to go heavy on the application. We'll keep it at the 18% and work our way up from there. Like I said, we'll do probably corn again here, and then we'll switch to beans if we get that far into it. But that'll be essentially the plan for that year. Across the road, I think this is all going to be beans next year. I think this is what we got to do. We'll make this one big field, turn it all into beans. Actually, I'm seeing some corn stalks down there, which hopefully we can knock over with this. I think we can. Interesting that we completely missed that. It was pretty good. I should run out of seeds before fertilizer. I'd be very disappointed if that's not the case. Let's see the other tractors. There they are. He's moving right along. That's good. So we like to see field 8, actually. Let's take a look. So the yield on field 8 was not the best. We also don't know what that entails. So we probably should have soil information on that one. So let's go ahead, get it. Nitrogen, it is good. We've already purchased that one, so we know that one's good. I mean, I think we got to update that soil information there. Which we'll wait. Yeah, we'll definitely wait on that one. But yeah, so I'll let this all run for a bit. We'll probably jump back in the following day. So I'll see y'all then.
Thank you.